Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Epic Games has just officially released Unreal Engine 5.6, and in this video we'll be checking out everything new inside of Unreal Engine 5.6. There are tons of updates including new user interface, meta-human creator integration, new gameplay templates, massive updates to the animation editor, procedural content generation, retargeting, and so much more. So in this video we'll be covering over every new feature and update introduced in Unreal Engine 5.6 and everything you need to know about it. And if you are new here to the channel, my name is Smart Polly and I make all sorts of Unreal Engine news and tutorials, so don't forget to leave a like on the video and subscribe. And without further ado, let's get right into the video. So the first massive update to Unreal Engine 5.6 is the brand new MetaHuman Creator integration. In order to create custom MetaHumans, you had to previously go through a website to design and customize the MetaHuman, and then you had to download it to your PC, which was a very slow and tedious process. But now in Unreal Engine 5.6, they have completely integrated the MetaHuman editor, meaning you can now create MetaHumans from inside of Unreal Engine without having to leave the editor. And to access this new MetaHuman creator, all you have to do is include the MetaHuman creator core data in your download of Unreal Engine 5.6 and then go and enable the plugin inside your project. And along with the new MetaHuman creator, they've also introduced brand new MetaHuman presets that allow for more diverse and realistic looking characters that was previously not possible with the provided presets. In addition, they also introduced these new body sliders so you can fully adjust things like the weight, muscle, height, and so much more. And along with that, these new features in 5.6 also introduces a brand new resizable MetaHuman clothing system, so when you customize or change the body shape of your character, the clothing automatically adjusts to the new changes, so you don't have to go to an external program to resize the clothing. Another new big MetaHuman feature in 5.6 is that you can now use 2D videos to create facial animation data for MetaHumans, along with a brand new 5.6 MetaHuman real-time facial animation from a single camera or audio source. Basically, this allows users to generate high-fidelity facial animation in real-time, and this was also demonstrated live during the State of Unreal, only using a consumer-grade webcam to generate this facial animation, which is honestly pretty impressive. Now, with all the new MetaHuman updates out of the way, let's move on to some other massive changes. And before we get into those massive changes, I want to make a quick announcement about my Unreal Engine 5 multiplayer survival game course. I've just added the last few lectures to the remastered course, and if you guys want to learn how to make your own game inside of Unreal Engine, this is honestly one of the best courses that you can take, as it shows you everything step by step and includes things like creating this drag and drop inventory system, gathering system, open world map, building system, save and load system, and even showing you how to set up the listen server and dedicated server hosting. There's just over 270 plus course lectures, and you can get full access to the course on my website, smartpoly.teachable.com, for just a small one-time purchase when compared to other Unreal Engine courses that charge in upwards of $300 or more. So kickstart your game development journey right now and pick up the course, link in the description below. And with that being said, let's get right back to the video. Unreal Engine 5.6 is introducing brand new UI changes. Basically, they have moved around all of the buttons that were previously inside of the viewport and rearranged them and organized them into this brand new toolbar. Things like the view modes, the snapping tools, and so much more have been organized into this sleek new toolbar. In addition to these changes, they've also gone and updated the content browser UI as well, so you can see that they included new changes to the layout. Another big change inside of Unreal Engine 5.6 is the new gameplay templates. Starting off with the first person and third person templates, they have been completely changed and rehauled, with massive optimizations being done to the templates to reduce the overall packaging and memory footprint of the default templates. For example, the new mannequin features lower resolution textures and uses a lot less memory than the 5.5 mannequin. In addition to these changes, they've also added 8 brand new gameplay templates, ranging from a horror game template, first-person shooter game templates, racing game, top-down action RPG template, real-time strategy game template, a 3D side-scrolling template, a 3D platforming template, and a third-person fighting game template. Now, I've already made a video showcasing all of the 8 brand new templates in detail, so if you are interested, I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Animation in Unreal Engine 5.6 is also getting some massive upgrades, featuring brand new UI layout and precise workflow, new focus controls, motion trail updates, mirror pose tools, and sequencer curve editor improvements, including tween tools, have been added. And another cool improvement for animators is the new Media Viewer plugin, allowing you to import and view directly in-engine 2D references so you can animate side by side without ever having to leave the engine. Speaking of animations, in Unreal Engine 5.6, there's a brand new Rig Locomotor plugin, which is currently experimental, that allows you to set up procedural walking inside of Control Rig, such as a spider walking along various geometry at runtime. You can set it up for any type of character, and this can be very useful if you don't want to keyframe animate characters' foot placements over certain terrain. And while we're on the topic of animation characters, retargeting is also getting its own new update, featuring a new scale proportion retargeting, allowing you to retarget different scale proportion characters. So if you have a super tiny character, and if you want to retarget to a larger one, you can do so with ease. PCG is also receiving a fair share of updates, including the new Biome Core version 2.0 plugin, which has a bit of notable changes, along with new PCG nodes and operators. Motion tools are also receiving a fair bit of updates in 5.6, including this brand new cloners and effectors that allow you to reveal hundreds of objects like this ArcViz scene all in real time. Chaos Cloth and Flesh plugins are also receiving updates in 5.6, and some of the features were additionally showcased in the State of Unreal Witcher 4 tech demo, including the Chaos Cloth simulation on the character, which the collision just looks so much better with every single update, and the new Chaos Flesh simulation on the horse, which creates some of the most realistic muscle deformation that was previously not possible with just simple skeletal mesh deformation. Another cool feature in Unreal Engine 5.6 that nobody is talking about right now is the new audio subtitle plugin, which is designed to support in-editor runtime subtitling from any adjacent subsystem that might need subtitle support. So I think this is like a real-time or runtime subtitling for games, so you could use it for things like maybe in-game voice chat, cinematics, or whatever else you might need to be subtitled. Along with that, we have a new quick render feature, which allows you to render a quick movie or sequence with just a click of a button. You can quickly customize your render settings to export as your desired format and just render out a sequence without the need of placing a cinematic camera. And this is honestly just a massive time saver, as you can just quickly render with a single click of a button. Another neat feature that is experimentally introduced in 5.6 is the new seamless gameplay transition for cinematics. Basically, this new plugin allows for Sequencer to be able to seamlessly transition character animations in and out of gameplay, which is absolutely necessary for things like creating a RPG story-driven game. And it's just another cool feature that I think I might check out in a separate video. Also, another feature in 5.6 that I haven't seen many people talking about is this new Iris networking system. The Iris networking system is Epic's next-gen replication framework, and it now supports advanced scenarios like entity-based replication, multi-server setups, including massively multiplayer online games or MMOs. So will you be able to create your own MMO inside of Unreal Engine? Well, it looks like Unreal Engine 5.6 is actually making this possible. Now, there are a lot more other minor updates and changes in Unreal Engine 5.6, but without making this video a whole 45 minutes long, I will instead include the link to the patch notes and the public roadmap in the description below, so you can check out all of the new features out on your own time. But if there was something in particular that caught your interest in this video, let me know down in the comments down below, and I will try to make a follow-up video about it. Anyways, that's pretty much it for this video, so don't forget to leave a like on the video and subscribe for more Unreal Engine content, and I'll see you guys in the next one.